to learn question number 1 from exercise 7.3. It looks too lengthy but very easy. Okay, very very simple problem. Now you see triangle ABC, this triangle ABC and triangle DBC are two isosceles triangle on the same base BC. Okay, are on the same side of BC. Okay, that means this A and D points are lying on the same side of BC. That means not this side, only this side. Okay. So this ABC triangle is isosceles and DBC also isosceles. So these two are equal and these two are also equal. Okay. Then if AD is extended to intersect BC at P. AD is extended to, okay, BC at the point P. Right, children? Show that triangle. So, one by one, I will explain. Okay? Listen very carefully. We will see first bit. Okay? Triangle ABD. That means this triangle. Okay, children? That means this triangle. ABD triangle. This triangle and ACD triangle. That means this small triangle. Okay? This part and this part. We have to show these two are congruent to each other. Okay. So now you see the here AB side, AC side. Because this triangle ABC is the isosceles triangle. For that AB equals to AC. Yes. Okay. Then triangle BDC also isosceles. That means this BD and CD also same, BD and CD also same, right? And this AD is common. AD is common. So, three corresponding sides of two triangles are same. That means by SSS congruent rule, this triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Very simple. Okay? First bit over. I am not writing here. You will do yourself. Okay? But explanation part, you follow very clearly. Then you see the, okay, when this small triangle is, this ABD triangle is congruent to this ACD triangle, that means this angle equal, right? Because these two are corresponding angles, okay, these two will be equal over. Then now, we come to, we have to prove triangle ABP, that means this big triangle. Okay, ABP, ABP, you see my hand, that means this whole triangle and ACP, this triangle also, we have to prove congruent to each other. Okay, children, very simple. See, from this triangle, AB equals to AC, AB equals to AC, corresponding sides are equal, right? One thing over. Then this AP is common. Okay. AP is common. Second condition also over. We got second point also. Then we required one more point. Right. When this ABD triangle, ACD triangle are congruent by first bit. Okay. These two angles are equal. So now from this triangle, ABP triangle and ACP triangle, these two angles are equal. Okay. So, now you tell me, you think yourself, how this triangle ABP, ACP are congruent to each other. By which rule? This side equal, this side, angle and side. By SAS rule, this triangle ABP is congruent to triangle ACP. Right, children? So, second bit also over. Okay? Now, see, when these two triangles are congruent to each other, this BP will be equals to PC. Right? Because you see this BP and CP corresponding sides. That means these two are equal. Okay? Now, what we have to prove? AP, third bit you see. AP bisects angle A as well as angle D. Okay, so now you see this AP line. Yes, when these two angles are equal, this AP line bisects angle A. That is proved already. Okay, that is over. AP bisects angle A. But now we have to prove this AP line bisects this angle D also. That means we have to prove this angle equals to this angle. Right? Now you see, when you are taking only this much of triangle, which triangle? Triangle DBP, in triangle DBP and triangle DCP. Okay? You see DB equals to DC, DB equals to DC. Okay? And BP equals to PC, BP equals to PC. Right? Then this DB is common. This DB is common. Yes, children? DB is common. So, by SS congruent rule, these two triangles are congruent to each other or not? Right? These two triangles are congruent to each other. When these two triangles are congruent to each other, this angle will be equal or not? Angle BDP equals to angle CDP by CBCD. Yes, children? Right? So, here AP line bisects angle A as well as angle D also. Okay, children? Now, we will see the question number 2. AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle ABC. Okay, here I am going to take isosceles triangle. Okay, ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay, children? And AD is an altitude of an isosceles triangle. That means like this. Okay, here you take point D, in which AB equals to AC. Because ABC is an isosceles triangle, so AB side and AC side both are equal. When this AD is an altitude of this isosceles triangle, in any triangle also, altitude means what? Here, this one is perpendicular. Okay? This line is perpendicular to the base of BC. Then only AD will be the altitude of this triangle. Right? Now, what we have to show? First bit you see. AD bisects BC. Okay? This AD bisects BC. That means we have to prove BD equals to CD. Right? So, for showing BD equals to CD, what we can do? When you can able to show triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. If you can able to show this one, you can tell this one is bisects the BC. Right? Because in these two triangles, what this BD and CD both are corresponding sides. Okay? When these two triangles are congruent to each other, then you can tell these two corresponding sides are equal. Right? So, in that way, we are going to prove AD bisects the BC. Now, you see, in these two triangles, now, till now we didn't prove. Okay? So, in these two triangles, AB equals to AC. AB equals to AC. Right? Then, what we have? We have AD is common. Right? This AD common. Right? Till now, we got two conditions. We need one more condition also. What is the one more condition? Here, this AD is the altitude. That means here, 90 degree. So, that means what? This ABD triangle, ACD triangle, both are right angle triangles. Right? So, by RHS rule, see, by RHS rule, what RHS rule? Here, hypotenuse should be same. Here, perpendicular. Yes? RHS means what? Hypotenuse should be same. Okay? And right angle should be there. Yes? In both triangles, right angle is there. Okay? And what is one more thing? Either this side should be equal. Here, AD is common. That means side also is there. That means by RHS rule, these two triangles are congruent to each other or not? Yes? So, triangle ABD, triangle ACD. These two triangles are
congruent to each other. When these two are congruent to each other, by CPCT, you can tell BD equals to CD. By CPCT. Okay, children? So, that means AD bisects the side BC. First bit over. Now, you see the second bit. AD, this AD bisects angle A. Here also you same thing. See, when you are taking these two triangles, ABD triangle, ACD triangle, this angle A is common. Right? Corresponding angles. Okay? This angle also corresponding angles. When these two triangles are congruent to each other, these two angles are equal. That means when these two angles are equal means what? This AD line bisects this angle or not? Right? So, second bit also open. By CPCT, you can tell AD bisects the angle A. Okay, children? Thank you all.